हाँ, नाउ इट इज क्लियर राइट। गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग। यस, नो इट इज देयर, यू राइट, यू सी द एडजस्टमेंट ऑफ योर फोन, नाउ एवरीथिंग इज क्लियर, लेटेस्ट। नो इट इज देयर, यस, नाउ लेटेस्ट स्टार्ट, म्यूट द माइक्रोफोन, नाउ लेटेस्ट स्टार्ट। C is the initial point of E1. Ha, true or false? We have done up to D. We have done up to D. Ha, yes. Ha. No. CR. It is now very much clear now. Ha, now it is clear, right? That I will see. C is the... Ha. It is clear, you see the adjustment of your phone. C is the initial point of ray CF. CF. So this is my ray CF. This is CF. CF. So, yes. So what is the initial? Initial means starting. Initial means starting. Now it is clear, right? Initial means starting. Initial means starting. So, starting point of CF, draw this. Starting point of ray CF is C. Yes, mute the microphone. And ray CA, CA. Ray CA, CA. CA also, yes. CA. Mute the microphone. This is my CA in this way. So, starting point of CF, CF, mute the microphone. Starting point of CF and CA, they are same. That is C. So, answer is true. Answer is true. We write true because C is the mute the microphone. Mute the microphone. It is very much. Mute the microphone. Last time I am giving the warning. C is the initial point of. C is the initial point of ray CF and CA. Answer is true. Yes. Mute the microphone. Because the ray CF. The ray CF starts from C. And goes towards F. The ray CA starts from C, goes towards A. So C is the initial point. Initial point is point. Initial point. Initial point is same as starting point. Now next is point B lies on the line segment CE. Line segment CE. This is my line segment CE. This is my line segment CE. CE. Now where is point B? Point B lies outside. Point B lies outside. So point B does not lie on that line segment CE. Because point B is outside. So answer is false. Answer is false. So point B lies outside the line segment. Yes, everything I will store. Point B lies outside. Right, outside. Point B lies outside the line segment CE. Point B lies outside the line segment CE. This is my line segment CE. Where is point B? Point B lies outside. So point B does not lie on the line segment CE. Point B, yes. Mute the microphone. Next time I will not allow Jiteshri. Yes. Next time they will not be allowed. Point B lies on the line segment CE. this is my line segment CE. Point B lies outside. Point B lies outside the line segment CE. Point B lies outside the line segment CE. Point B lies outside the line segment CE. Because this is my point B. There is point B. This is my line segment CE. Point B does not lie on that. Let her write. I am storing all the chat. She will be asked the question after reopening of the school. Point B lies outside the line segment CE. Are my dear, I told you that let her write. No, I will give you her the reply. Let her write. Even after several reminders, she is writing, let her write. The school will ask her the question. Now, 11th question. 11th question. 11th question is omitted. 11th question is omitted. Write the difference between line, line segment and ray. That is omitted. Write the difference between line, line segment. Now it is clear, right? Write the difference between line, line segment and ray. That is omitted. 11th question. Difference 1 is omitted. Now before we start next exercise, we have to study the concept. Intersecting lines. See, we take two line. This is my one line. This I will name it as AB. AB. Then we have another line, this I will name it as CD. So there are two lines, AB and CD. Now these two lines, AB and CD, meet, they cut intersecting line. Line AB and line CD, they cut each other at one common point. They cut each other. Write on this. Line AB and line CD cut each other at one common point. That common point is. So this. This I will name it. No. You see the adjustment of your phone. Everything is clear. So this is my point. This is my point P. You see the adjustment of your phone. So write line AB and line CD cut each other, or you can say meet each other. I am explaining first. We are given two lines AB and CD. They cut each other or meet each other at one common point P. Write down. It is very much clear, right? Line AB and line CD. Cut each other at one common point P. The lines, line AB and line CD, they meet each other or cut each other at one common point P. So we are given two lines, one is line AB and other is line CD. They cut each other or meet each other at one common point P. The line AB and line CD, they meet each other or cut each other at one common point P. Let me explain now. Why are you interrupting in between? Let me explain. Line AB and line CD, they meet each other or cut each other at one common point P. So whenever two lines cut each other at one common point, the lines AB and line CD are intersecting lines. So whenever two lines cut each other, line AB and line CD, they are intersecting lines, and point P is called the point of intersection. So whenever two lines intersect each other at one common point, whenever two lines intersect each other at one common point, the point P is called point of intersection. Yes. Right. Whenever two lines cut each other, then the lines are said intersecting lines, and whichever point they cut each other, that point is known as point of intersection. Then we have this next concept, parallel lines. Parallel lines. Now let us take two lines. One line is AB. Other line is CD. Now if you see the figure, the line AB and line CD, they do not cut each other. So whenever line AB and line CD do not cut each other, then they are not intersecting lines. So whenever they are not intersecting lines, they are parallel lines. So right? So write line AB and line CD. They are not straight. They are not intersecting each other. That is why they are called parallel lines. So line AB and line CD are parallel lines. Yes. Whenever they do not intersect, they will be parallel. Railway tracks are parallel because they never cut each other. Railway tracks are parallel. Line AB and line CD. If you see the straight line AB and line CD. One minute. Forget about that railway line. You see the ruler. Ruler has opposite sides. If you see the opposite edge of the ruler, they never cut each other. Yes or no? So line AB and line CD are parallel lines if they do not cut, if they do not cut each other. If they do not cut each other. If they do not cut each other, they are parallel line. It is denoted as it is denoted as we write line AB and how we denote line, we write two arrow. Line AB is parallel to, so for parallel symbol two vertical line, parallel symbol means two vertical line. Line AB is parallel to line CD. Line AB is parallel to line CD. Intersecting line we do not denote. For intersecting line there is no symbol, but for parallel line, two vertical line is the symbol of parallel lines. Line AB and line CD, No, they do not cut each other, no. They do not cut each other. Remember this. If they cut each other, the train will collide. The bogies of the train will collide. It will fall down. Railway track is not moving, but there seems to be a parallel line. Wherever the tracks are changed, again you from that changing point you will find again two lines, no? Wherever it changes, from there also you will find Now let us see third one. Let us see the perpendicular line. So first we have seen intersecting line. Intersecting line means line they cut each other at one common point. Whenever two lines do not cut each other, whenever two lines do not cut each other, they are parallel lines. Now next is perpendicular lines. So let us see, we are given two lines. One is line AB. Line AB, we have another line that is CD, right? Line AB and line CD, first of all, they intersect each other at point P. So perpendicular lines are intersecting lines. Perpendicular lines are intersecting line. They first intersect each other. And P is the point of intersection. Now at the point of intersection, the 90 degree angle is formed. So at point of P, the 90 degree angle is formed. At point of intersection, 90 degree, these two lines, they make angle of 90 degree at lines AB and CD intersect each other at point P. They intersect each other at point P, and and at point P of inter and at point of intersection P and at point of intersection P angle of 90 degree is formed. And I am explaining. First I have to explain. So perpendicular lines are intersect. Perpendicular lines. Write on this. So perpendicular lines are intersecting lines. But what is additional part in that perpendicular lines? They intersect each other. But at the point of intersection, 90 degree angle is formed. At point of intersection, the 90 degree angle is formed. So perpendicular lines are intersecting lines. Okay, I will write. Perpendicular lines are intersecting. Perpendicular lines are intersecting lines, but at the point of intersection, 90 degree angle is formed. So that is the additional condition for perpendicular lines. Perpendicular lines means yes. Perpendicular lines are intersecting lines. Now we'll see perpendicular bisector. Now next is perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular bisector. Now we'll see perpendicular bisector. Is it clear? So now there are two lines. Let us take the same. AB. We are having the line AB and line CD. First of all, they are intersecting line. They cut each other at one point P. That point P is called point of intersection. At angle P, 90 degree, at P 90 degree is formed. But what is there? The AB, line AB divide line CD into equal parts. So CP, so length CP will be same as length PD. So CP and PD will be same. CP will be same as PD. Line AB divide line. Line AB divide line segment CD. All of you mute the microphone. Now listen carefully. There are two lines AB and CD. They intersect each other at point P. Second thing, at point of intersection P, angle of 90 degrees formed. So line AB and line CD, they are intersecting line and they are perpendicular lines. Line AB and line CD, they are intersecting lines and they are perpendicular lines. Now second thing, now this line AB divide line segments line CD into two equal parts. So this CP, the length of CP will be same as length of PD. This line AB divide line segment line CD. So right, lines AB and line CD. See here, only line AB divide line CD. we cannot say other way that line CD divide line AB. No, line AB divide line segment line CD. So line AB and line AB and line CD are perpendicular lines. They are perpendicular lines. Line AB and line CD, they are perpendicular lines, and line AB divides line CD into two equal parts. Line AB divide line CD into two equal parts. That means PC is equal to this much length. PC is equal to PD. PC is equal to PD. So here line CD is perpendicular bisector. Line AB is perpendicular bisector of line CD. So line AB is called perpendicular bisector of CD because CD is divided into equal parts. Line CD is divided into two equal parts. So AB is bisector of CD. We cannot say other way. CD is not bisector of AB because AB is not divided into two equal parts. CD is divided into two equal parts. And which line divide? Line AB divides. So AB is called perpendicular bisector. AB is called perpendicular bisector. It is clear?
Yes. It can be anyone. See. Ask the doubt.
Yes, that angle will be given 90 degree. Is it clear? So we have seen the concept intersecting line. Because 90 degree means we say perpendicular means they make the angle of 90 degree at point of intersection. Both the line make angle of 90 degree at the point of intersection. Both the lines make angle of 90 degree at the point of intersection. So when both the lines meet each other at point P, and point P 90 degree angle is formed, means they are perpendicular. Second thing, when CD is divided into two equal parts, we say AB is a bisector of CD because CD is divided into two parts. Second thing, at P 90 degrees formed. So we say perpendicular bisector. If AB divides CD, then we say only it is a bisector. But if at P angle of 90 degrees formed, we say it is perpendicular bisector. So now next exercise 10.2, we immediately start. 10.2. Now first, state whether the given lines are parallel, intersecting, perpendicular or perpendicular bisector. So let me draw all the lines. You have to also draw, yes. No, I am just writing the question only, no. Whether the lines are parallel, intersecting, one and the same. state whether the lines are intersecting, parallel, perpendicular or perpendicular bisector. So this is A. Now B. B. This is A. And then we have B. A, B. Then C. Draw this first. This part you have to complete. A, B. A, B. A, B. We have to check whether the lines are intersecting or they are parallel or perpendicular bisector. No. Now see. Write C. Yes. Let us write C. This is one line. This is other line. Then D. C, D. This is C, D. Yes. C, D. C, D. Yes. Draw this. Yes. Mute the microphone, please. Now see here. Now in this you make this 90 degree and this is divided. This is not shown in the textbook. I am asking you to show this in the textbook. This is 90 degree and this is divided and this is 90 degree. This is not shown in the textbook. I am asking you to show this. Let us see first line. See here. Now what is intersecting, because no. First one is intersecting because here the line can move at both the end. So when this line moves this side, this line moves this end, and this line moves this end, they cut each other. At this point they cut each other. So when you move the line further, the lines can move at both the end because it has arrow at both the end. Arrow means it can be extended further. So when you extend this end, they cut each other. So this first one is called intersecting lines. First one is called intersecting lines because when you extend the line. Now second one, what is? Yes, because they cut each other at this point. So this second one is also intersecting line. Second one is also. No. Third one is not parallel. See here. Third one. Two line cut each other at this point, and at this point 90 degree angle is formed. But this line do not divide this. This is small. This is bigger. So this line do not divide this. So only it is perpendicular lines. This is only perpendicular lines. Perpendicular lines. What about fourth one? Perpendicular bisector. Because these two lines cut each other at this point, angle 90 degrees formed, and this line divide this line. So perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular. Because they cut each other at 90 degree, no? They meet each other at 90 degree. Perpendicular bisector. Then E1, they are parallel. How much you will extend the end? They do not meet. The line can be extended. So they are parallel lines. They are parallel lines. Because when you extend the end, they do not meet each other. I have fourth period and the link is same. A division, B division. Yes, bye bye.
Bye bye. Bye bye bye.